Hey, welcome back. It's Caroline again. Today we're going to talk about something that hits a little closer to home for me and maybe for you too. Today I'm going to share how exercise helped me, physically and mentally, along with some of the other numerous benefits that come along with cardiovascular exercise. We will also get into discussing how cardiovascular exercise can actually help regulate diseases like asthma. I don't know about you guys, but there have been times where I have felt pretty insecure about myself and working out. Whether it is trying out a new class for the first time and just simply showing up to it without knowing anybody, or wondering if I will be able to keep up with everyone else in the class. There's so many different options for exercise these days. Which is a good thing, don't get me wrong, but all of those options can definitely be intimidating, especially if the whole working out thing is new to you. Assuming you're like me, you want to do everything in your power to live a healthy lifestyle. That means having a healthy body, too. Sometimes this is easier said than done. I try to push myself past my fears or insecurities in order to reap the benefits of cardio exercise. Did you know that long-term physical activity leads to a lower resting heart rate and lower blood pressure? This decreases your risk for heart disease, which in turn lowers your chances of a heart attack. Now, I know what you're thinking. I'm 16 years old. I'm not going to be at risk of a heart attack anytime soon. Until I'm at least 70 years old. Okay. But I want you to try to think about it this way. Our body is like a bank that we're constantly investing in. The more we invest, the stronger and healthier we grow. The longer we invest, the healthier we are in 40 years. But if we wait until we're in our 50s to take our health seriously, it'll be much harder to get to that point. Just like it's much harder to make money if you wait to invest late. According to the Cleveland Clinic, cardio exercise can also benefit brain and joint health and may reduce your risk of other diseases or illnesses in the future, such as dementia or Alzheimer's. Let's face it, I know you'll want to remember myself, Coach Chloe, and all of the great things you already have and will continue to learn in this course. Speaking of brain health, when you're active, your brain releases chemicals called endorphins. They are also known as the body's natural painkillers. Your body produces endorphins when it feels pain or stress during activities like exercise. After all, exercise can be somewhat painful. Endorphins are a natural painkiller, and at the same time, they produce positive feelings. Think about it. Have you ever been in a bad mood after you completed a workout? Also, let's be honest here. As teenagers, we've all struggled with acne or breakouts at least once, right? Well, did you know that being active helps increase circulation, which leads to clearer, healthier skin? Yes, please! There are so many benefits to exercise and cardio workouts, I could literally be here all day discussing them with you. If you have a few extra minutes, I encourage you to do your own research and see if you can find one that I haven't mentioned. According to the CDC, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, at least 60 minutes a day of physical activity is encouraged. This is anything that gets your heart beating faster. That seems like a lot of time, but think about it this way. This could be something such as going for a run or playing soccer. And you can bet that those workouts with Coach Chloe count. So, get your heart pumping. Try to be active every day. Every minute counts. Thanks, Coach Chloe, for those 3-minute AMRAPs. Just remember, something is better than nothing. Speaking of hearts beating faster, I have asthma. Maybe you do too. So sometimes once my heart starts beating faster, I go into an anxiety, like panic mode, because I feel like I can't breathe. If it gets too difficult to breathe, then I start to panic, and with asthma, that makes it that much harder to try and breathe. Take deep breaths. Take deep breaths. So along with already being in a new and uncomfortable situation, I used to be at times embarrassed and almost insecure about how to handle my asthma in these situations. Now, I will say first that I am not a doctor, so if you do have asthma, please consult with your doctor before trying something new. Did you know there are many Olympians and professional athletes who also have asthma? Like the NFL player Treylon Burks or the NBA player James Harden. Now, if you follow football or basketball, you know these guys don't let their asthma hold them back from anything. Did you know, even though asthma inflames your airways, regular exercise can actually decrease inflammation? Exercise reduces inflammatory proteins, which improves how your airways respond to exercise. Through working out, your lungs are getting stronger without worsening inflammation. Let's touch back to Tennessee Titans player Treylon Burks. During training camp in July of 2022, he passed the conditioning test and participated in practices without any issues. According to NFL.com, he says that he needs to continue to keep up his conditioning and continue taking his inhaler. Now, remember, always speak to your doctor about the use of your inhaler if you have one. I think it's important for us to realize that we aren't alone on this journey. And even though you sometimes might be worried that getting breathless from exercise might mean an asthma attack is on the way, remember that over time, exercise actually helps those asthma symptoms. Getting started into a routine of exercise can be challenging, to say the least. But if you make yourself do it and start making a habit and a routine of it, then it gets easier. Trust me. Especially once you start seeing and feeling the positive results. It can make you feel like a new person. If the thought of a habit and a routine sounds scary to you, don't stress. We are going to be discussing healthy habits next time. I will be breaking it all down for you, starting with how to build a healthy habit. At any heart rate, I'll see you next time. I've gotten into a habit of saying that.